Namaste, yogis. Welcome back. I'm Chintamani Cloud, and today I've got a vigorous sequence for the yogis that need to move their bodies. We'll get a full cleanse. We'll do a lot of traditional sequencing, alignmenting, and we're really going to focus on the breath. I'm going to be cueing a lot, so that gets in the way for me of my pranayama, but I really want you to focus on your slow, rhythmic, and even inhales and exhales as you move the body today. So if you've got a yoga mat, we'll throw that down to get started, and I'll meet you there. Let's get ready for our sun salutations to begin warming up the body by making our way towards the front edge of our mats. We're going to ground down evenly and equally through the right and the left side of our bodies, and we're going to come right into our alignment. If you need to do some shoulder rolls to find that alignment, we want to remember to lift those shoulders up, draw them back towards the spine, and then ultimately they're widening apart. And if you need to turn your palms to face out to help with that shoulder alignment as you tuck your tailbone under. And now we're gonna talk about drawing in and closing all the gateways that live along the spine. And this is our warming up right here in stillness. We find our mountain pose. So we need to find strength within. We need to find the strength of the core. So we're gonna tap into all the muscles that live along the spine. And we're gonna take that with us now as we inhale our arms up and overhead. Exhale, diving forward into your first forward fold. Maybe you'll walk out your feet for a moment. Now let's inhale to our half lift. Exhale, bending into the knees. If you're ready for your float back, I'm gonna do this first sun salutation nice and slow. Let's pause in plank position. Top of a push-up. Now we wanna take our core on board with us. We wanna engage all the muscles that live along the spine. We want a posterior tilt of the tailbone, and we want to take all this on board with us for that lightness of being. As we exhale, you can use the knees if you need to, and lower down. We'll come all the way towards the floor. Pull your hands back a little bit, roll your shoulders back, push your pubic bone into the floor as you engage your glutes. We're gonna tuck the belly in, engage the core, maybe look up, and exhale, lower down, pushing up through your modified plank, or full plank as you lift up and back into downward dog. And you can go ahead and start walking your dog if you'd like, or coming into some stillness right away. Checking in with the nasal passageway, we'll see if it's clear today. And if it is, we'll draw the breath in and out of the body through the nose. We need to tap into those muscles that live along the spine here in downward facing dog so that we can lengthen correctly. And then we're gonna go ahead and inhale onto the balls of the feet. Exhale, as we bend through the knees. You can walk or float your feet forward. As your feet come up to meet your hands can stay on the floor or lift off. Inhale to your half lift. Exhale to your forward fold. Release the neck and head. And we're gonna inhale to lift up. Strong mountain pose, Tadasana. Exhaling, Samasthitihi. And we're gonna do our next sun salutation, spicing it up a little bit more. We're gonna add a little bit more plank, chaturanga, deep core. So getting ready, taking the breath with us now. Inhale to lift our arms up. Exhale to dive forward. Inhale to our half lift. Exhale, you can float back or step back using the knees if you need to. Find all your engagements. Exhale, lower down. Inhale to your half lift. Maybe you're ready for your upward facing dog or your cobra. Exhale, downward facing dog. Right away, trying to find the alignment. So we're not trying to stretch the armpits, we're strengthening them. We're opening up through the calves here. We're strengthening through the shins. So activate through the feet, the fingers. Now we're gonna inhale forward into plank position if you wanna lengthen your plank. Crawling your toes a little bit further back, then tuck that tailbone under, draw in through the core. Take an inhale breath here. Exhale, lower down. Inhaling, upward facing dog. Exhaling, downward facing dog. Walking your dog if you ever need to. We're finding stillness as we open up through the calves, strengthen through the upper body, lengthen and realign the spine. Inhale forward into plank. Exhale, Chaturanga Dandasana. Inhaling, Urdhva Mukha Svanasana. Exhaling, Adho Mukha Svanasana. Really warming up the body now. Inhaling onto the balls of the feet. We're going to exhale as we bend through the knees, walking or floating the feet forward. Inhaling. Half lift, exhaling. Full fold. Inhaling, arms overhead, shoulders lower down the back. Exhaling, samasthitihi. Getting ready for our sun salutation B now. Bending in the knees, inhaling the arms up to your chair pose. Watch the core. Exhale, dive forward. Inhale, half lift. Exhale, chaturanga. Inhaling, urdhva mukha svanasana. Exhaling, adho mukha svanasana. Now, if you want to lift your right leg up first, go ahead. I'm going to do things traditionally here. I'm going to do a small step with the left foot. I'm even going to lift onto my right fingertips here to make space. I'm going to draw my right thigh and knee up into the chest to place my foot up in between my hands. And I'm going to get ready for warrior one. Inhaling the arms up and overhead. We draw the shoulders down the back. Exhaling. Inhaling. Exhaling. Inhaling. And exhaling. And getting ready for our second side. If you'd like to inhale the left leg up and back, you can. I'm going to do traditionally a small step with the right foot, a big core engagement, and a floating of the foot forward up in between the hands, establishing your foundation. Rise on an inhalation to your Virabhadrasana A. Your hands can be wide apart or closer together. Exhale, lower down, Chaturanga Dandasana. Inhaling, Urdhva Mukha Svanasana. And exhaling, Adho Mukha Svanasana. This is where we get to realign in the spine. Calm the mind. And come back to the breath. We're inverting the body here. We're preparing for inverting the body even more deeply as we strengthen the shoulders and the shoulder girdle here. We lengthen the spine. We find our core. Inhaling onto the balls of the feet. Exhaling as you bend through the knees, walking or floating the feet forward. Inhaling to your half lift. Exhale to your forward fold. We're coming back to bend into the knees. I'm going to tuck the tailbone under, drawing the core in. Shoulders lower down the back as arms straighten to lift. And then exhaling, samasthitihi. You can shake that out if you need to. Shoulder rolls are always groovy. And now we're going to get ready to lengthen our sun salutation. So hopefully we're all feeling that good heat from within. And we're going to use that to go deeper into the hips now. And deeper into our sun, our standing postures, and finding our core. So taking this all on board with us, we tuck the tailbone under, we draw the ribs and navel in, shoulders are widening apart back behind us. We're gonna do our sun salutation, we're gonna hold our chair pose, Utkatasana, 5 deep breaths. So I'm gonna bend into the knees. Inhaling, arms wide apart, or in time, shoulders widen, hands touch, 4 more breaths. Tucking the tailbone under, drawing the ribs and navel in as you deep breathe. Now we're gonna exhale, we're gonna dive forward, trying to straighten out the legs, engaging the quads. We push the chest, lengthen the spine along the legs. Inhale, half lift. Exhale, Chaturanga Dandasana. Inhaling, Urdhva Mukha Svanasana. Exhaling, Adho Mukha Svanasana. So we're gonna do our warrior one. Little step with left foot, big step with right foot. I find my foundation, I take my core on board, and we're gonna stay here for 5 deep breaths. We're gonna be pulling right hip back, drawing left hip forward. We're gonna be pulling the right side body back. Pull your right ribs back, your right shoulder back, as you draw your left ribs forward, your left shoulder forward. One more breath here, and we're gonna exhale to lower down. Find a low lunge, plank. Engage the glutes, floating down. Inhaling and exhaling. And for second side, I'm gonna demo this. So I'm gonna turn around on my mat to demo this from the other side, but you can of course stay as you are. Coming into warrior one on our left side. Stepping left foot forward, inhaling arms up. We're gonna pull left ribs back, left shoulder back, and then hands can be together or they can widen apart if it helps with the shoulder alignment, okay? Those are some variations, but in time, we're learning to keep the shoulders in the girdle and straighten the arms to bring the hands together. We're gonna take one more breath here, and then we're gonna exhale and lower down, finding low lunge, inhale plank, exhale. Inhaling and exhaling.
And then inhaling onto the balls of the feet, exhaling as we bend through the knees, walking or floating the feet forward. Inhale to your half lift, full fold. Inhaling, chair, tuck the tailbone under, draw the ribs and navel in. Exhaling, samasthitihi. And I'm gonna come back to this side. So I'm just moving around on my back, on my mat for our filming purposes, but you'll stay at the front edge of your mat and we'll get ready for another sun salutation. We're gonna be adding on. So incorporating some shoulder rolls here as we find our samasthitihi. Inhale our arms up, we're gonna drop our left arm down, exhale out over towards the left. Couple deep breaths here. Inhale up to center, both arms lift, exhale second side. Just reach your right arm down as you lift your left arm over. Then we're gonna inhale the arms up, exhale, getting ready, chair pose, bending at the knees, inhale, arms up, exhale, dive forward. Inhale, half lift, exhale, chaturanga. Inhaling, Urdhva Mukha Svanasana, exhaling, Adho Mukha Svanasana. So we're gonna add on here, we're gonna come into warrior one, bringing right foot forward. We're gonna open right up into warrior two. So if you wanna adjust with that left foot opening up, we wanna make sure we pull this whole left arm back. This right knee's gonna wanna follow. We need to make sure we continue to externally rotate it. We keep the tailbone tucked under, the ribs and navel drawn in. Twisting through the neck, lengthening right up through the spine for one more breath, and exhale to release. We can windmill those arms down. We'll find ourselves in a low lunge into plank. Chaturanga, you can always use the knees if you need to. You don't always have to foot above the floor. And now we're gonna get ready for our second side, coming into warrior one now. And then opening up into warrior two. And I like to pivot through that back foot to open the toes up. We keep the tailbone tucked under. We pull this whole right shoulder back. We make sure we externally rotate with left knee. And then we're gonna exhale to release, windmilling down, get a nice stretch through the side bodies. We find low lunge, plank, chaturanga. Getting ready again to add on to our sun salutations. Inhaling onto the balls of the feet, exhaling as we bend through the knees, walking or floating the feet forward. We're gonna inhale to our half lift, exhale to our full fold, bending into the knees, inhaling. And exhaling. We're gonna add on one more posture to that sequence. So one breath, one movement. We're gonna go to warrior two, and we're gonna add on from there. Inhaling, chair pose. Exhaling, forward fold. Inhale, half lift, chaturanga. Right foot forward, warrior one. Warrior two. Take an inhale breath here. Exhale, extended side angle, either pausing here or coming all the way towards the floor or a block. Extended side angle. Five deep breaths here. Inhaling to lift up to warrior two. Exhaling to release. We'll meet in downward dog, getting ready for second side when you're ready. Left foot comes forward, warrior one, into warrior two. Into extended side angle. Left forearm can stop at the quadricep or fingertips can come to the floor or a block. You could also be on your fingertips instead of your palm. Tucking the tailbone under, trying to draw the ribs and navel in as we peel right shoulder back here, left shoulder forward. Inhale, warrior two. Exhale, release. Inhaling onto the balls of the feet, exhale as you bend through the knees, walking or floating the feet forward. We're gonna inhale to our half lift. Exhale to our full fold, bend into the knees, inhale, arms up, chair pose. Exhale, samasthitihi.
Getting ready now, we're gonna bring our hands towards our hips, bending into the knees. We'll step out into a wide-legged forward fold position. We're gonna find our alignment. So I like to use the Sanskrit word bandhas to describe the core system, and it's threefold. We've talked about it in previous classes, our pelvic floor, our core, and actually our neck, and then our breathing apparatus, that system. So we're trying to draw the tailbone under, lift the ribs and navel in. We're lengthening up through the back of the neck and head. We're imagining lifting our own head off of our body as we tuck the chin in. And with hands at hips, I'm gonna inhale my arms out to the sides and exhale to dive forward. My hands are kind of under my shoulders here to start. Lengthening the spine on my inhale, I start to walk my hands back. Notice I'm not gonna move my fingers or my palms, I'm just sliding them. The fingertips aren't gonna change in direction. And I'm gonna watch, my hips are gonna wanna go back, I'm gonna bring them forward, and I'm gonna use my arms to pull my torso into the gap between my legs. Taking deep breaths here, pushing the sit bones up to the ceiling. We're lifting this up. We're lengthening the spine for one more breath, then we'll walk our hands forward. Take an inhale. Exhale, hands to hips, bending the knees if you need to. Inhale to lift up. Exhale, roll the shoulders back. We're gonna bend into the right knee, turn the right toes out. We're gonna get ready for Trikonasana, or triangle pose here. Watch the temptation to steer that left hip out. Bring the right hip forward, tuck the tailbone under, draw the ribs and navel in, inhale your arms up to a star. Now I'm gonna invite you to turn your palms to face the screen. We're gonna take an inhale here, and now without moving arms, without moving shoulders, just tilt through the side bodies. Keep your core on board. Try to now from this position, continue to draw, engage through the inseam of your right side body to lower your fingertips towards the floor. And if you'd like to, your gaze can stay on the floor or it can tilt up. I'm continuing to push into this calf and lift this left hand to the ceiling to create this opposing force that's gonna help you lengthen across your collarbones for one more breath. I like to shift my gaze towards the floor here, bending into right knee. We can inhale safely up. Exhale, hands to hips. I'm gonna bend into right knee, pivot through heel, turn the toes forward, second side. Finding bandhas. Inhaling, turning palms to face the screen, exhaling. Deepen some pranayama, inhaling. If your drishti is facing the ceiling, we'll draw towards the floor. Bending into left knee, we'll inhale to our star position. Exhale, hands to hips. Bending into left knee, pivot through the heel. All 10 toes once again facing this side. We're gonna inhale our arms out to the sides. Exhale our hands back behind us. We're gonna find a clasp of all the fingers. And now, instead of clutching our hands here, we're gonna try to pull the shoulders back and widen the arms apart. Excuse me, and widen the palms apart as the shoulders are pulling back and widening apart also. And now I'm trying to find the engagements of the inseams of the inside of the legs and the outseams of the legs. So we're gonna try to draw in all of our muscles here as we inhale, lengthen the spine. Exhale, now think of the spine lengthening means I have to look back behind me. So you wanna get to that position. And then sometimes on days where I'm really tight, it's nice to use the floor a little bit to help push my head in, lengthen my spine, lift my sit bones up and push my hands down. You can stay here. If you need to come out early, that's okay too. We'll aim for two more breaths. And then if you need to bend in the knees as you lift up, find your core, lengthen your spine, inhaling, exhaling. And you roll that out through the shoulders if you need to. The neck and head too. Okay, and then we're gonna bend into the knees. I'm gonna pivot through the left foot and I'm gonna bring both feet towards the front edge of the mat and shake that out. Okay, shoulder rolls. And we're gonna bring our hands to our hips. We're gonna step our right foot out once again. And this time I'm gonna bring my hands back behind me for reverse prayer position. Now, if we don't have a reverse prayer position, we could try for the fingertips, or maybe you'll start to crawl for wrists, forearms, and opposite elbows. So see where you're at. We're opening up here into your position. We wanna make sure that the shoulders are pulling back. That's the gesture. We also tuck the tailbone under, draw the ribs and navel in. Now I'm gonna bend into my right knee, pivot through my right heel. And now I need to bring my left hip on board. So I'm actually gonna step a little bit, off of my left heel. And now my hips are gonna be nicely paralleled and facing in the same direction, and my toes are also, and they're also on two parallel lines, but they're not on the same line. So they're on two separate lines, right foot and left foot, making two parallel lines. We'll take a nice inhale here. Exhale, dive forward. Pull right hip back, draw left hip forward. Try to lengthen the torso towards the right leg. 5 deep breaths. If you need to come out early, that's okay too. Now as you inhale to lift up, you can release your arms or keep them there, pivoting through the feet, through the heels. I actually lift my right heel now to help create those two parallel lines. Take another inhale breath here. Exhale, dive forward. Inhale to lift up. Exhale, we come forward. We're going to release our arms. Come and roll through the shoulders. Good. And then we'll bring our hands towards our hips and the heel toe, the feet closer together, and step them out. We're gonna get ready to do one last standing posture. We're gonna balance on one foot, so it's gonna be definitely the most challenging, perhaps. And this is gonna take, and then this is how we'll be ready then to come towards the floor and to move into our hip opening and our core work before closing the sequence. So, standing in stillness now, if you haven't already, even and equal weight distribution between the right and left side of your body. We find our bandhas. We tuck the tailbone under, posterior tilt. Now this sometimes means this to some people, but not to yogis. Posterior tilt with core on board, shoulders rolling and widening apart. So we're gonna take the neck and head too into this alignment. And now I need it all on board, and I'll go ahead and mirror. So you're gonna do it on your, you're gonna be stabilizing through your right leg, and you're gonna shift all your weight into the right side body. And instead of collapsing out to the right, you're gonna lift this left hip up. Go ahead and lift the knee as high as you can and try to grab the big toe. If this isn't in your practice today, maybe you'll stay here or maybe you'll aim for this kind of leg extension. If you've got the big toe, maybe you've already extended, so we'll aim for 3 more breaths here. Grounding down through this right side, really try to lengthen and grow up tall. And then you're gonna just hold here. If you wanna add the fold, go ahead. To for 3 breaths, so we'll aim for 2 more here. Inhale to lift up. Now, if you want to open to the side, you can do it with a bent knee or keeping the leg straight, opening out to the side. We really want to draw this in, this right hip in, this left hip up. If you want to take your gaze back behind you, you can. Now we'll go ahead and inhale if you're still with me. Exhale to release. Inhale to lift up. Exhale to let go and hold as long as you can. Draw the core in, draw the hips in, and release. And you're gonna feel that in the quad really strong for some of us the outer hip and glutes. Maybe you'll feel it everywhere if you've got that connection to that strength-based alignment where we're really trying to involve all the muscles into our alignment. So getting ready for second side, the spine, the weight comes into our left side, but we don't want the hips to draw out, they have to lift in. And by drawing this left hip in, now my right hip lifts up and I can float this foot up as high as I can to grab that big toe. Maybe you'll do the extension here or with a belt. Maybe you choose not to. If you've extended the leg, we'll aim for 5 breaths where we're just trying to lengthen this leg and this leg. Deep breathing. Then 5 breaths in a forward fold, or 3, excuse me. And then we're gonna lift up on an inhale. And if you'd like to, exhale out to your side with a straight leg or a bent leg. And we gotta really find our core here. You can use your arm coming out to the side for counterbalance. Then we're gonna inhale the leg up straight. If you'd like to exhale with me and then let go of the leg, see how that goes. Draw the core in, hips and glutes. 1 more breath, inhale and exhale. Whew. So that's a posture that, when I'm practicing regularly, almost seems gentle and sweet. But on times where I don't incorporate that into a daily practice, then I start to, even with it daily, it definitely challenges our balance. So we'll let it go with a sun salutation and we're gonna get ready to translate towards the floor. So we'll come towards the front edge of our mats. Inhale the arms up, exhale forward fold. Inhale to half lift, exhale chaturanga, inhaling and exhaling downward dog.
And we're gonna use this as an opportunity to realign the spine before we come to a seated position. All right, so if you're ready to jump towards the floor, if you've got a jump through practice and you know what I'm talking about, feel free to jump through. I'm gonna kind of break it down a little bit. You can come onto your fingertips if you'd like, but I'm gonna stay on my palms. I'm gonna lift onto the balls of the feet, bending into the knees. I'm gonna try to lift up and draw the core in to help draw my feet towards my hands. And then trying to come into a low squat position. I'm gonna keep finding my core as I place my hands towards the floor. And just to make sure I'm even on the mat here as I sit my glutes down and extend my legs forward. Now we're gonna lift the shoulders up. We're gonna roll them back behind us. We're gonna push in. We're gonna straighten out our arms, straighten out our palms here, engaging through the pecs. We're gonna push the spine back. We're gonna imagine we're lengthening our spine up a wall behind us. And we're gonna draw the core in. And now find your legs too for two more breaths. Good, and release. Now we're gonna bring our hands. You can choose any clasp that you like for your forward fold. Maybe you'll do the pinky, big toe clasp with the peace fingers. You'll clasp the sides of the feet. If you can't touch the toes yet, that's okay. Inhale, lengthen the spine, exhale, fold. Now if you're fatigued, you can do a more yin style, but otherwise we're gonna try to engage the legs, engage the core, and imagine flattening the spine down towards the legs, using the core to engage. I'm even pulling on to my feet to help draw this in, and I gotta watch those shoulders. They wanna creep forward. We need to pull them down the back, and you can stay here for as long as you like. Traditionally, we're here for about 10 breaths, and now we're gonna inhale to our half lift, and exhale to lift up to a seated position, keeping the core on board. We're gonna bring our hands back behind us, getting a deep stretch here through the backs of the wrists. Now you could do this with a straight leg position. If it doesn't work for you, you could do this modified with bent knees, but I'm gonna do it with straight legs. We're gonna push the soles of the feet towards the floor. We're lifting the hips up. It's gonna engage the glutes. We're gonna try to squeeze the knees together, lifting up, looking up. If you wanna release the neck for one more breath, and then drawing the core in, we release the hips down. We come into our seated position. Roll through those shoulders. Now we're gonna cross the legs and we're gonna do a little bit of core work here. We're gonna try to hold the feet off the floor and draw these thighs into the chest. One more breath, then we're gonna roll over, extend into plank, optional vinyasa here. Find your core, find your alignment. And from here, we're gonna incorporate a little bit of side plank. So from downward facing dog, we're gonna inhale onto the balls of the feet. We're gonna come to the outer edge of the right foot. I'm gonna pay attention to where my wrist is because I want my right shoulder to come right above my wrist, and then I want my hips to stack, ultimately my shoulders to stack. We want the tailbone to tuck under, the ribs and navel to draw in. And then if we can lift up, we wanna push into this base right hand, lift the hips up, draw the core in for one more breath, and then we can release, optional vinyasa. And we're gonna get ready for our second side. So you can always do this with one knee down, but I'm gonna do the full extended plank. So extended side plank, so paying attention to where that left wrist is in line with left shoulder. We wanna tuck the tailbone under here. You see, the temptation is glutes are gonna draw back, so we need to draw them forward. Tucking the, now we wanna engage here through the inseam of the side body. So lift up for one more breath. And then we'll release, optional vinyasa. And we're gonna come back towards the floor. So we're gonna inhale onto the balls of the feet. Exhale as you bend the knees, walking or floating the feet forward. Squatting position. And actually, let's stay in this squatting position here. Widen the feet apart. Turn the toes out. And then we're gonna try to lengthen the spine, trying to draw in through the deep belly, the high belly, widening those shoulders apart. And then from here, we'll do a little stretch, extending right arm, reach left arm up, take an inhale here. And exhale, release, second side. We're gonna get ready to come into a nice balancing posture, doing some more with the core and the upper arms. One more breath. And exhale to release. So if you'd like to come into this arm balance with me, we can do this crane pose. And if not, you can stay in your squat position or whatever you'd like to do instead. So if we're gonna come into our crane position, you can also just explore the first stages and see what each one feels like. So I'm gonna bring the hands onto the floor. I'm gonna straighten out my legs a little bit here, but staying bent into the knees. As I start to walk, my feet in closer and closer. So my thighs are getting really close to my legs. And now as I bend, kind of recreating that squat position, I'm gonna bend into my knees, now bend into my elbows, and I'm trying to, this is where the core comes in, tuck those knees high up on those arms. And then we're gonna bend into the, lean into the arms. Oops, I came too far forward. And then we can float those feet off the ground. And we wanna try, the temptation is gonna be belly's gonna wanna draw down. We wanna lift it in and float up. If you want to, you can see what it's like to try to aim to come into plank from here. It's not always that easy. You can do one leg at a time, see what it feels like. We'll see what it looks like here. Chaturanga, inhaling and exhaling. All right, so we did some fun arm balancing here. Getting our shoulders ready for back bending. We'll inhale forward towards the, to bring the hands and feet together. Finding that squat, feel that core engage. And now we're gonna get ready to do, to take our core into boat pose right here. So we'll pause right here. Lengthening the spine, you can use this alignment right here where you're pulling your thighs in towards you, and I'm holding on to my shins, so that I can pull my shoulders back and lengthen my spine. Resist this temptation. Here we go. Now you can choose your boat pose, holding the legs or not holding the legs. And we're gonna extending the arms or not extending the arms. Watch this, it's hard. Draw the belly, lift the belly in. For one more breath. And let's vinyasa. Rolling over into plank. And coming back into downward facing dog, getting ready to jump through. Or transition back through our float forward and squat. We'll extend the legs and get ready to open the hips up a little bit here. So we're gonna inhale that right foot in, open right knee out, getting ready for head to knee pose, Janushirasana A. And we're gonna do a few poses on one side before we switch to left side. So, you're opening, you're opening your right knee out and I'm opening my left to mirror. So we'll do it this way. So hopefully we're on the same side here. Let's take a nice inhale to lengthen the spine. And this is core work. Think about, for some of us, the tightness in the back of the legs or the tightness in the hips keeps us from even engaging our bandhas in these stretching shapes because the emphasis is so much on the stretch. But if you've got the flexibility, then see if you can start to find the core to help you lengthen your spine along your extended leg for one more breath. Let's go ahead and inhale to lift up and exhale to roll the shoulders back and sit up tall. Now we're gonna float this right leg in. This is gonna be kind of challenging here. We're gonna keep this right foot and the right leg in. I'm gonna bring my left hand to the side and lean to the left a little bit. Inhale, right arm up. We're gonna lean in here. In between this right leg, I'm gonna stretch this right shoulder forward and I'm gonna try to bind. Now, some of us will stay right here. Some of us will start to lift up and up and up. And if you can, bringing the hands together to meet and bind around the right leg. We'll take an inhale to try to lengthen the spine and pull the shoulders back and exhale to draw forward any amount. If that's too much, stay at each stage, okay? Two more breaths. If you need to come out early, that's okay too. Inhale to lift up. Exhale to release. We're gonna roll the shoulders back and now we're gonna try for a twist. Draw the core in, bring your right hand back behind you. This time we're gonna inhale, left arm up and exhale. We're gonna try to bring the outside of this left shoulder to the right knee. And now I'm gonna use my left hand to really push me forward. So I really want this leg, this right leg and this left side body to meet. And I'm gonna try to bind. So it might be hard for you if you've never done this posture before, but we aim for this shape and you can keep your back hand on the floor to support you. If you can, you can find the full bind. This one is really hard to find the full bind for at the beginning of a person's practice, but it is achievable. So stay for as long as you can. Coming out early if you need to. We'll go ahead and release as we inhale to lift up and exhale to extend. And now we're gonna do that on our second side. So a little bit of awareness there that our core takes on a new meaning when we're trying to feel these engagements, these low, deep twists. So we'll find that on our second side. So now, it's my right leg, but your left leg draws in as we inhale. Exhale, open the knee out. Make sure the hips stay square. Inhale as you extend yourself over your right leg. Exhale, fold forward. As many deep breaths here, maybe five. Just trying to find the opening in the hip, trying to externally rotate this left leg. As we lengthen the spine on the floor, we'll go ahead and inhale to lift up, half lift. Exhale, roll the shoulders back as you sit up tall. Inhale, draw your left knee up again. And exhale, draw the foot in nice and close. So now we're gonna find this closeness. We need to bring this leg nicely in. And now the way I'm gonna invite us into it is I'm gonna take my left hip off the ground and lean a little bit into the right. And now I'm opening to go around. You see my palm facing up. That helps with the rotation of the shoulder, okay? And then maybe you stay here, maybe hand stays on the floor, maybe lifts up. And what we're trying to achieve is a lengthening before we compress forward. And wherever you are, trying to hold it for three, maybe five breaths. And then we're gonna inhale to our half lift. Exhale as we release. And now we're keeping the knee bent in for that deep twist. It may just feel like a stretching sensation for some of us at first, that we're just so tight that we can't get into it. But in time, we're gonna learn about our bodies and our core, and we're gonna find that it's really related to our core experience, our ability to lengthen the spine here. Draw your left hand back behind you. Use your right hand to squeeze the thigh and the chest together. And now I'm twisting. So as I twist, maybe you even take some moment here to twist, look back, help you extend your right arm and bring your right shoulder to the outside of your left knee. Now I've got to turn my palm away. That's what creates the rotation in the shoulder that allows for the positioning of the hands to find the clasp and the bind on our second side. So some of us are gonna feel only stretching here, and some of us are gonna be able to feel how this is really, really engaging, especially those obliques, the back muscles. If you haven't released already, we'll go ahead and inhale to lift up. And exhale to release, and we'll go ahead and shake that out. And we're gonna try to balance that with a little, one more set of boat pose, but with an option of doing a little bit different in alignment, actually coming into a different posture here. So you could either repeat boat pose or lifting the toes up. I'm gonna try to grab the big toes, draw the core in, lengthen the spine. You could do one leg at a time, coming into that position of pointing the feet, but pulling the toes back. Oops, and now what we need to do is find the core, find the gaze. So that's what we need to do here. Find the core, the gaze, the breath. And stay there for as long as you can. When you're ready to release, let's squeeze those thighs into the chest. If you want to, try to lift off the ground. And if you want to feel what a traditional vinyasa building that strength would look like for the float through, you can try to float yourself through. Taking in one more chaturanga here. All right. Now we're gonna come again to a position of laying on our back. So as I come forward here, I'm gonna extend my legs, and now I'm gonna lower down. And we're gonna get ready for back bending here, our deep back bending. If you wanna take a little bit of a moment here to twist, you can draw the knees from side to side, release a little bit in the lower back. So if you have a full wheel position, I'll invite you to practice wheel as many times as you're comfortable in general. In this sequence today, I'll give us the space to do it one time. And then I'm gonna move on in the sequence. And if you are not into doing the inversions with me, you can keep repeating any back bend that you feel comfortable with. So at this point, if you need to modify the practice in any way to close the sequence in a way that feels right to you, feel welcome to. And in our position here, we're gonna bend at the knees, draw the soles of the feet towards the floor, and starting off coming into bridge. So some of us will stay right in bridge, going on bridge variations. But for those of us coming into boat, bow. We need to tuck the tailbone under. We need to draw the ribs and navel in here. And I'm going to bring my hands back behind me. And I'm not going to place any weight on my head. I'm going to try to lift right up into position. Then we're going to try to tuck the tailbone under, squeezing through the glutes, drawing the ribs and navel in. Deep in sound breathing. You can come out early if you need to. Otherwise, 5 or 6 deep breaths. And when you're lower down, now I did that for fun, I guess. I don't usually like to do that though, lifting onto the heels. I try to stay really controlled through the core as we lower all the way down. And we're gonna bring the knees into the chest and give the massage to the lower back. So if you'd like to, you can go on and do, if you were just doing bridge there, you can continue that. If you're ready to come into any more back bends, you're welcome to. And I'm going to start to invert the body now so that we can get ready to close the practice. But my little microphone protection puffball is playing games with me today. All right. So from here, we're going to come into a revert. We're going to revolve our position. So I'm going to still draw my knees into the chest, and I'm going to try to roll into a deep upper back stretch. I'm coming off on my yoga mat a little bit, so I'll come forward here. And then from here, I'm going to use this as a way to bring my hands together, to roll my shoulders under my back, and just get a nice, we want to push into the back of the head here to lengthen the neck, and to open up into our plow position from here. Deep in sound breathing. Now, if you have a full shoulder stand, feel welcome to go into there from here. And you can do that one leg at a time, or both legs at the same time. And we're really trying to lengthen the spine here. We're trying to push the neck and head into the floor. And we're trying to now lift these hips up, up, up as much as you can. You can stay here for as long as you can. You can come out early if you need to. If you're coming out, we'll come back into our plow. I'm going to interlace my fingers, though, for that nice deep shoulder stretch. Try to bring my feet towards the floor. And you could stay in plow. You could bend at the knees, coming into a snail variation. And I'm not going to invite us into the full shoulder stand sequence. From here, I'm going to invite us back into plow, bringing the hands towards the lower back. We're going to roll the hips towards the floor, shake the feet out towards the ceiling. And maybe roll through the ankles a little bit. Maybe we'll extend the arms into a T and then open up into cactus arms here, gazing right and gazing left to stretch out the neck. All right. And then from here, I'm going to invite us to come into a last inversion with the option for making things accessible if you don't have headstands. So I'm going to swing my feet back just to give myself a nice roll forward. Oops. And I'm going to roll all the way into a vinyasa. And now from here in downward dog, we can come into full headstand position, dropping down to the hands and knees. We can lower down onto our elbows, coming into our headstand position. Or if you don't have a headstand practice yet, coming into dolphin for 5, 10, 15, 20, 25 breaths, whatever your practice invites you into. So dolphin is a great way for us to start to open, to strengthen the shoulders, to strengthen the core and the spine. And you can also walk your feet in as you try to lift your hips up and then even lift one leg at a time. And if you're in a headstand and you're ready to come down, I'll invite us all to come into a child's pose. Now, I'm going to invite us to inhale to a seated position. And we're going to come into a seated cross-legged position. Or if you have a half lotus or full lotus position, I'll invite you into whatever hip opening cross-legged position feels comfortable for you. We're gonna roll through those shoulders. We're gonna get ready for a seated forward fold. So you can choose to do this in just a cross-legged position, a half lotus or a full lotus. If you've got the arms clasped and you're in a full lotus, this is a great shoulder opener. If you wanna do this where you grab the opposite feet. If you can't grab the opposite feet, remember when we did our reverse prayer, we talked about grabbing the fingers, the wrists, forearms, or opposite elbows. So take any clasp that work for you then. We'll lengthen the spine, pull those shoulders back, draw the core in as we inhale, and we're gonna come forward, trying to bring the chest and thigh and calves together. So don't be afraid of them touching. We actually want them together as we try to bring the head towards the floor. Aiming for 5 deep breaths here. And we'll inhale to lift up and exhale to release. And staying in any comfortable seated position that you have, I'll invite us to chant the mystical syllable Om together 3 times to close our practice. So we'll close the eyes if you'd like to. Take a couple of cleansing breaths. A deep inhale now. Sighing it out the mouth. We'll do that 2 more times. And this time we'll inhale to Om 3 times. Oh.